All right, mic up. Test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from the track and field stadium at StubHub Center. LA Galaxy 2 is on the air tonight to take on the OC Blues. How's that? That works. And Christian is on headset as well.
Sorry, there. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, what a turnaround this season, Joe, for the LA Galaxy. Actually, didn't start too well at the start of the campaign, but now 10 wins in the last 13 games and a golden opportunity to take sole possession of first place. All right. It was really deep, insightful stuff, wasn't it? Profound, almost.
Looking to spend a night out with the family? Galaxy family four packs get you four tickets, hot dogs, drinks, and stars.
A midweek classic.
Purchase your Sandy at LAGalaxy.com.
Yes, we're good. I got it. What happened was the email that Lori sent me was corrupted.
Okay.
And nothing showed up. So I just emailed her back.
It's awesome.
Yeah, I got kind of busy. So,
check out LAGalaxy.com/camps for a full schedule of dates and locations.
All good.
Did anybody already fax your levels out to?
We just did.
You just did?
Yeah, we just did now.
Man, you are old, Joe. Laser light show. Wow. Is it Jovan or Jovan?
Jovan.
Or Jovan.
San Diego product.
Yeah. By way of Manchester United via Birmingham City.
From the Track and Field Stadium at StubHub Center, welcome to LA Galaxy 2 action tonight. The Galaxy junior side facing the OC Blues. Hello again and welcome. Joe Tutino here. Glad to have you aboard tonight. I'm joined by Christian Miles in for Ralph Perez. You know, Christian, the last time we worked together, we worked for a company called Fox Sports World. But we've never done a game together. Welcome and thank you.
Thank you, Joe. Thanks for having me. And some big shoes tonight, filling in for Ralph Perez. Los Dos, the talk of USL right now. An inauspicious start to the campaign. Wham! 10 wins in their last 13, and a great opportunity for Kurt Anolfo and the boys to take sole possession of the Western Conference. It's not going to be easy, though. Look at this Orange County team. They're in a bit of a tailspin right now. They find themselves in sixth place on the cusp of that last playoff spot, flirting with disaster possibly. They'd love to turn it around, and you know, Joe, they'd love to turn it around against one of their Southern California rivals.
Of course. The nice little rivalry between the L.A. team and the team from Orange County, although the Galaxy have had the better of the OC Blues so far this season. This is the third time they're going to meet through the campaign. Galaxy winning 3-0 and 2-1 respectively so far this campaign. So the games have been competitive, but the score lines haven't.
Yes, indeed. You know that sits in the back of a player's mind no matter what level you're at right now. And Orange County, they're also trying to turn things around. I mean, three games without a win and contrasting form as you look at the Galaxy. We talked about 10 wins in 13, but they are banging in the goals left and right. That's got to put a smile on Kurt Anolfo's face, but we're seeing stability from front to back, and they're also getting the job done defensively already this season with six clean sheets. So they're riding the ship after a shaky start, and things are really coming together, Joe.
Ariel Lassiter, 8 goals on the season, leading the way for Galaxy 2. Raul Mendiola, who is getting some looks here now with the senior team, and this is what this is all about. Get your experience in here. You might get a chance with the senior side Galaxy.
Yeah, and that's the whole point of this reserve team system. You want to mesh the reserve team with the top level. The LA Galaxy have been prime examples of being able to do that.
Galaxy OC Blues. The players are in their procession when we return. The game gets underway. Stay with us.
Lakers take the lead. Wayne Gretzky, the Los Angeles Galaxy, are the first to five.
This is Los Angeles, the city of champions. Since 1996, we have been honored to represent LA. We are a dynasty forged by homegrown heroes and global superstars. We are a club defined by greatness. We draw inspiration from the champions that came before us. Our winning tradition was forged at hallowed grounds like Staples Center, the Rose Bowl, and Chavez Ravine. Everything we do for Los Angeles. All of our championships are dedicated to you, our faithful supporters. The first to five, and built for more. We are the LA Galaxy, and we are handcrafted in Los Angeles, the city of champions.
We welcome you back to the Track and Field Stadium at StubHub Center alongside Christian Miles, Joe Tutino. Galaxy OC Blues about to get underway. Galaxy come in 32 points, 17 games played. Christian, you talked about it in the opener, 23 points for the OC Blues through 17 games, right on the edge of that red line to make the postseason.
Yes, indeed, and we mentioned the fact that these are both two teams heading in very different directions. I mean, the playoffs aren't that far away right now. Orange County really need to put together a good run of form, but when you talk about good runs of form, this LA Galaxy team, we talked about 10 wins from 13, 5 unbeaten, currently the second longest run in USL, but it's the way they're going about their business. Twice in the last three games, the Galaxy 2, Los Dos, has managed to score at least three goals, in fact, four goals in those three games. So they're doing with regularity, and they're starting to find that link between midfield and attack. We talked about how solid they've been at the back. So it seems to be a very balanced LA Galaxy 2 team, a good test for them tonight.
Something that we talked about earlier, they struggled early on the first 3 weeks of the season. Although they didn't panic. They knew they were going to get it going because Kurt Anolfo felt, hey, I have talent on this team. In this league, I have talent in order to compete and take care of business. I think once these guys got confidence and had the confidence to play the game they know how to play, things started looking good.
Yes, and familiarity will breed confidence, and the more they play together, the better off they're going to be. They have a great understanding. Nice that they just played over the weekend and had a great 4-0 win against Sacramento Republic, got that huge monkey off their back. Mm-hmm. It's been a big lift to their psyche, and they take on a team that they've had a pretty good run against here in Orange County. All things are clicking right along, but you're only as good as your last game. The time is now for the LA Galaxy and Los Dos to get it going. The depth of talent, though, is one thing that really stands out to me. You look out there, and you got players like Travis Bowen, you've got Jack McBean. These are players that can feature in the MLS top level, and when you have that luxury at your disposal, a lot of success normally follows.
Let's get you the starting lineups. First off, the visiting team, Pepe Miranda in goal for the OC Blues. His defense will have Jeffy Payeras with Brenton Griffiths and Beto Navarro as the center backs. Josh Suggs will play on the left side according to this lineup. In midfield, Luka Petricevic with midfielder Milton Blanco, Didier Crittenand, Pavle Popara, and Denzel Slager. That's five in the midfield with the lone forward, Chris Cortez. For the LA Galaxy 2, Clement Diop in goal. His defenders will be Joe Franco, Daniel Steros, and Dave Romney are the center backs. Bradley Diallo, the left back. Ariel Lassiter will start right side at midfield. Alejandro Covarrubias, Andre Aras are your central midfielder, and Jaime Villarreal on the left side. Up top, it'll be Travis Bowen and Jack McBean. And our contest is underway. Blues in there, well, blue uniforms, and of course the Galaxy in their customary white with the blue sash as it comes forward here for Travis Bowen. Throw in here for the Blues.
You mentioned Joe, McBean, and Bowen. That's a lot of pace and a lot of power. It'll be interesting to see how that LA Galaxy starting attacking duo will impose their strength and that power on those central defenders. It's going to be very interesting to watch.
Bowen will play the customary target forward. Here's the offside, the passive offside, that lovely passive offside. It's called the OC Blues. And restart here for the Galaxy. As I was saying, you know, Jack McBean will play mostly underneath, and Bowen likes to play up top as that target forward. We'll see how that works.
Pace and power. We'll see how it works out. A lot of people are expecting to see perhaps Kainoa Bailey, or we'll see an advanced role for Ariel Lassiter. There's a lot of firepower, a lot of goals in this Los Dos 11.
Here's Bowen off to Villarreal, looking for some help. He's got Aris on his right foot. He'll have to go back. He'll switch it on to the right side. Joe Franco. Steris, and they'll reset once again here from the right. He'll knock it forward. A little long here for Bowen, picked up by Miranda. On the bench, you talked about Bailey. Bradford Jamison available to Kurt Anolfo as well.
And that really speaks volumes to what you and I were just speaking about just moments ago. The depth of talent on this LA Galaxy 2 team is immense. Real strong start so far, trying to impose their will and dictate from the get-go. We'll see if it continues. The normal 4-4-2, as you would expect from Kurt Anolfo, and that diamond in midfield. It'll be interesting to see how Andre Aras and Alejandro Covarrubias forge their understanding, because that has been at the core of their success in recent weeks.
Galaxy trying to move this one into midfield. It'll go out of play for a throw. Kretinand. Good work there by Covarrubias. Turns into a throw-in for the Galaxy. So a good possession here. Covarrubias into Jack McBean. McBean stood up and taken off the ball quickly that time. It'll come back the other way. Here comes Popara sending long up the near side. Diallo didn't get enough of that one, and he's able to play it well. Stayed composed there and cleared back up the near side.
Yeah, slightly misjudged there from Diallo, but his athleticism gives him the ability to recover. We talked about the pace and power up top with McBean as well as Bowen. Got a lot of pace on the flanks there with Joe Franco on the right-hand side, and we're likely to see Diallo make some forays into the attack. We shall see.
Suggs able to play this one back. They'll try to go near side this time. This time Diallo with a good clearance into midfield, and Bowen. He's got Villarreal. He'll have to put it back, though. Trying to find some space here. It was a good idea, but you got to hit that one a lot better for Ariel Lassiter.
Just trying to settle in here and establish a rhythm. Easier said than done.
OC Blues on the attack. Pajares on the near side. Popara back out to Pajares. He tries to work his way through. Diallo gets plenty of help with Romney. However, it comes loose and a good chance here. Coming up for Slager on the cross in front is headed over the bar and out.
A real dangerous moment here on the left-hand side. The coverage from Romney trying to provide that coverage for Diallo. And astute play from Orange County, able to play it across. Wide open opportunity. And if you're Orange County, you're very disappointed with that. That's got to be on target. It has to be better. Another look at it here. And lost out by Diallo. Great little ball across there from Slager, and that one just popped high at that close of range. A disappointing finish.
OC again on the attack as it comes near side. Another ball down the right channel. This one too long for Cortez. And Clément Diop, he'll collect. He's got Romney on the near side. He'll find him. Good pressure here by OC Blues into the Galaxy defense. Romney again. He'll play it back to his keeper. Diop playing well right now, I'm told, for Galaxy 2.
Had a sensational game over the weekend, making two big stops to preserve his fifth shutout of the season. Really rounding into form. We know about his athleticism. We know about his ability to read the game, but his shot stopping has been magnificent as of late.
Here's Crittenden playing forward. Galaxy wanted offside. The flag stays down. Diallo getting back in time. In some trouble right now, though. He'll get some help from Romney. It comes all the way back to the keeper, Diop. And the Galaxy able to unlock that pressure for a moment. Here's Aris. Steris will work it on the right side. He's got Franco if he wants him. He'll play it ahead and find Covarrubias. Checking for this was Lassiter, but it'll come back again to Aris. Now Lassiter will start out on that right side, but he drifts in towards center underneath the forwards. We'll keep an eye on that. We almost had that pass down the middle of the park earlier from Bowen, who couldn't find him. Villarreal. It'll come up for Covarrubias. He's got Franco. He'll find him. He'll need some help on that wing. Nobody made the run for him. It'll come back out. This one a bit short. It'll be cleared away.
Just haven't been able to string it together in that Orange County half. The Galaxy looking for a little bit better understanding. Not exactly on the same page right now. You expect that in the early going, though, and that should work itself out.
Good work there by Steris, knocking it away. Aris won't get the foul, but Villarreal cleans it up. Covarrubias now. Lassiter on the left side wide open. Covarrubias did not see him. Lots of traffic there in front. Now he'll switch it. Here's Lassiter, bringing it down well, getting away from one defender onto his right foot, then closed down and cleared out there from Bradford Griffiths, or I should say Brenton Griffiths. Slager, he'll get the throw in.
Good coverage there from Romney. Great diagonal ball across there from Lassiter. Heavy on that first touch, allowing the center back to come over and cover for the right fullback. But that's the right idea, those probing passes, switching the point of attack and keeping Orange County on the back foot. LA will look for more of that as this one goes on.
Didier Crittenden, maybe they'll play it back. Griffiths. Navarro onto the left side this time. Here's Suggs. Again, Navarro. The Galaxy get everybody behind the line here defensively, compact down the middle of the park, which on this field, which is a bit more narrow than the big one inside StubHub Center, the main stadium, that makes it a little bit more difficult to get that width.
Real high line here from Los Dos, and they're trying to go direct just behind it, but Steris and Romney have been impenetrable thus far.
Here's a good chance for Cortez onto his right foot. He goes near post, and he scores. OC Blues open up the scoring here in the eighth minute and take a 1-0 lead.
The direct approach pays off, a high line, and Los Dos not exactly in sync and on the same page, and allowing Cortez with a wonderful finish here. He really picked his spot well, but the movement is what opens this up just in front of that back four, makes that slight diagonal run, but the finish is as tidy as it gets, takes it first time, bottom corner, good night, 1-0. And I have to say, a deserved 1-0 lead here for the Blues.
Well, what you see a lot at this level is that extra touch. Cortez did a good job of running onto it and one time in at home. A lot of times you'll see that extra touch to just get beyond the defender. Shot it, had the goalkeeper going the wrong way also. OC on top.
And that, Joe, is a great point that you make. I think that's one thing that really separates a good striker from a great striker, knowing when to hit it first time. Cortez, all credit to him, great judgment, wonderful placement.
Hole here for LA Galaxy 2, trailing 1-0. Romney will find Steris. Covarrubias. Franco as they try to work the wing. Lassiter on the right side, pushed back towards midfield. It'll come back out. Popara, I believe he was the player that sent in Cortez on the goal. Jack McBean, I believe this might be his first touch. 10 minutes in, he needs more touches than that, certainly. Romney, trying to find Bone, he'll knock it forward, clear it away. Possession Galaxy. Go ahead, Chris.
Yeah, very well dealt with here by OC. Moments ago, though, on the right-hand side, we see Lassiter drifting out of that wide role. Franco coming in aggressively. We know Lassiter not known for dropping back and defending. Fortunately, though, it's cleaned up nicely by Ulrich in the center of the park. LA keeping possession. What they need right now is a positive response because Orange County, they're feeling good about themselves. Their chests are puffed up. They know they're on the front foot right now. LA Galaxy trying to take some wind out of the opposition sails.
Plenty of time, though. Just 10 minutes in. Patience here. Diallo. He'll find Villarreal. Back out it comes. Diallo on his left foot here. He'll get the throw-in.
And with a big front line like that, you're expecting balls to be whipped into the box, and that's where Jack McBean is at his best.
Second ball here for Lassiter. He's able to knock it down for Bowen. Back to goal. Lassiter once again plays it through. This is easy for Miranda. He'll pick it up.
It's better, though, Joe.
Yep.
Better. We're starting to see a little bit more synchronization. LA coming out aggressively here. Heavy on the touch there moments ago from Diallo, but nevertheless giving the Blues something to think about.
Hey, see the future of the LA Galaxy when Raul Mendiola, Oscar Sorto, and Los Dos take on the Arizona United Sunday, August 9th at 4 o'clock at StubHub Center. Tickets are only $10 at LAGalaxy.com, and kids 12 and under, they get in free. Here's Navarro, able to play it left side. Blanco, he'll play forward. Cortez, and this will be easy for Steris. As the Blues tried to stay onside, they did. Andre Aris here. Here's David Romney. He'll have to go back to his goalkeeper. That's something the Galaxy building out of the back has been somewhat of an issue from time to time, trying to find that player. Is it Aris that's checking back? Is it Covarrubias that's checking back to get the ball, helping out those center backs?
Now tonight, it looks as though it's going to be Aris for the time being. So much of the responsibility lies on his shoulders, and they need to find that link from that deep midfield role up to those more advanced positions.
Here's Popara playing near side. This will get through on the near side for Slager. He's got it side of the six, trying to cut back. Great job by Diallo closing that down. It'll turn out to be a corner kick for the OC Blues.
A little bit of a rough start here for Bradley Diallo. Misjudges it for the second time here in the space of 12 minutes. But once again, able to recover. He stays with it, doesn't get his head down. A little bit of dilly-dallying, I'd have to say, from Slogger. However, Orange County still doing enough to get the corner kick.
Corner coming near side here. Didier Crittenden will take it. Goes short, top of the box. The attempted goal is blocked and cleared away by Auris this time around. That was Papara that got on the end of it. Now McBean. Again, knocked into the Galaxy defense, this time by Suggs. Blanco. Covarrubias, as the Galaxy try to find the rhythm here. This is going to be a foul. Hard foul as Covarrubias is brought down. Free kick, Galaxy inside their own half of midfield.
Excellent turn from Covarrubias, but he certainly took his licks on that one. But they need more play like that. Covarrubias, such a big part of the success on Saturday night against the Sacramento Republic up north.
Here's Romney. As we mentioned, top of the broadcast, the win tonight for the Galaxy. Should they get it, they take over first place in the West. This will be cleared away. Beto Navarro onto the left side. Back it comes defensively. Griffiths back to his keeper. Here's Miranda. 14 minutes in, Galaxy trailing by a score of 1-0 in this one.
Good shape from Orange County to stifle this LA Galaxy attack. Just seems to be stuck in second gear.
Here's McBean. Gets away from one defender. This looks good for Jack. Was he brought down from behind? No, says the referee. Covarrubias now from distance, and he'll hit it badly. Goal kick.
Yeah, every day of the week, that is a foul for me.
Yep.
As Jack McBean bowled over just in front of the penalty area. Surprisingly not awarded, though. That could have changed everything.
Still 1-0 in favor, OC Blues. I agree with you. I think that was a foul from behind. It's tough for the referee when they're trailing the play to figure out, is he diving or did he really take that knock? And sometimes it doesn't go your way sometimes.
Yeah, the referee's assisted across the field, wide open, and a good look at it. That's where the referee needs a little bit of help.
Here's Diallo, able to find Villarreal. Romney, I think it's fair to say this particular Galaxy side missing the talents of Raul Mendiola and what he does bring to that midfield and orchestrating going forward. His service, not there yet. See if they can find the answer in this match.
Yeah, it's his work rate, his ability to stretch defenses and really get the width. And, well, they're really missing his delivery right now, especially when you have that duo that flourishes with that kind of deliveries that he can provide. McBean, as well as Bone, you know they'll be licking their chops with Raul Mendiola serving those balls in. Mendiola currently at the top of USL with the most assists in the league.
And he unlocks Ariel Lassiter as well. Here's a good restart opportunity now, though, for the Galaxy. 16 minutes in, looking for the equalizer here. Andre Auris.
This is positive. He's been striking him very well. A goal in each of his last two. And provided a good line of service. He's certainly got plenty of willing takers in there with Keane as well as Romney up from that central defensive position.
Auris will get the go-ahead here. On his right foot, a big rainbow that'll come backside of the six, kept in by Diallo. Out to the top of the box, Villarreal, but a foul called against the Galaxy. And a restart the other way.
Well, commentator's curse, whatever you want to call that, Joe. It's just got to be better from Andre Auris. With that type of firepower inside the box, Auris's delivery not exactly hit with precision. Capable of much, much better.
Yeah, too much air. Too much air on that. It should come across on a line lower with more pace.
Do like the response, though, we've seen from Los Dos after that goal. Taking this game by the scruff of the neck. Better possession. However, they just need to find that link between midfield and the attack. It's starting to come together between defense and the center of the park, and a lot of that is going to be Covarrubias.
Getting that link. It's on the right side, Franco. Franco once again back to Steras. Romney. A little quicker speed of play would help this Galaxy team right now. It's allowing OC to play in their positions.
That's a very good point, Joe. It's a little bit stunted right now for Los Dos to settle in, knock it about, get your confidence, and play one through.
This one a bit long for Lassiter. So possession back the other way. It'll come back defensively here. Navarro, 18 minutes in. McBean trying to cut him off. It'll go back onto the left side. Suggs. All the way back to Miranda. He'll have to power into midfield. Cortez can't get on the end of it. Good work there by Steras. He'll knock it down for Aris. Trying to find Villarreal on that left side, and they're going to throw one out of it.
Good recovery by the left back, and nicely played out there from Griffiths. Something Los Dos will want to get more of. Villarreal hasn't had enough touches early on.
Diallo will find Bowen back out to Aris. Covarrubias leads it on to Franco. Here's McBean. Franco once again knocking top of the box. Good for Bowen. His shot deflected and out of play, and the Galaxy pick up their first corner of the evening here.
And that's much better. Positive energy, better movement, quicker one touch. That's what Los Dos is looking for. It pays off here in the corner. And we'll see if Aris can get his supply line right after that awful free kick just a moment ago.
Well, everybody will line up at the top of the 18. Steras near the penalty spot. McBean beyond him. Romney there as well. Here's Aris. He'll play it in towards the spot behind Steras, able to knock it down in front for Bowen. He heels it towards goal and is blocked and out of play. Throw it. Your five-time MLS Cup champion, LA Galaxy, presented by Herbalife, hosts Trinidadian champion Central FC in CONCACAF Champions League play. That's Thursday, August 6th, right here at StubHub Center. Tickets start for as low as $13 at LAGalaxy.com. Romney with a left-footed ball. He'll earn the corner.
It's better now, and you can see the confidence growing with each touch from Los Dos. They are settling in. It's taken them 20 minutes. But they're starting to get the better of the play on top of OC right now.
Second corner of the night. This one coming from the left side. This one should bend in towards goal. We'll see if this one's more on a line near post.
And he scored a sensational free kick, Aris. Game before last.
Here's Aris.
He has the ability, Joe.
Tried to go near post. It comes out to Lassiter, who knocked it down for McBean and didn't quite get to Jack. Another throw-in. So they did go front post this time around.
It's good to show a little variation in those set-piece approaches. Last thing you want to do is become predictable and easy to defend. You want to be a hard team to play against. That's part of the equation.
Diallo's long throw in for Bowen. It'll come down for him. He's able to keep possession. Squares it over to McBean. His right-footed ball is blocked. Lassiter now gets away from one defender. The left-footed ball on goal. Saved by Miranda.
That's more like it.
Yes.
Now it's starting to click on all cylinders. Lassiter getting involved. He's such a big part of the Los Dos attacking success. And when you move like this, and we see this little turn here from Jack McBean, a little bit slow, but it finds its way out to Lassiter. We know what he can do with his left foot. He can take advantage of those second balls as well as make those runs in behind. He's a multifaceted weapon going forward.
Careful here as we go back to live play. Here's an OC on the counterattack, the right-footed attempt. Suggs, too many touches, and the Galaxy able to break that one up. Back in the midfield, here comes the counterattack. Covarrubias sending long here for McBean. He's got Lassiter on the far side if he can find him. So that Villarreal coming down the middle of the park, and it's cleared away.
First really good opportunity as far as counterattacking is concerned, but you have to praise the recovery here from the Blues. Able to get back.
It'll come near side. Papara to Slogger. He'll run it near corner. Diallo defending. Across to the backside of the six and knocked away by Franco, not far enough. This is a good chance at goal, blocked and out of play. Off of Aris, this will be a corner kick. Papara taking a bit too much time. We talked about the goal by Cortez, the one-time shot at goal. This was a couple of touches, allowing for the defense to close things down. Fortunate for the Galaxy.
That cross cannot come in.
Right.
Diallo has to close that gap to be much better. It allows that one to come across and put more pressure. Just want it a little bit tighter.
Here's the corner kick. Comes into the area. And fortunate that time. Clément Diop able to get on the end of it. Now he'll quickly outlet into midfield. Intended for Lassiter. This will be headed away by Navarro. Galaxy win it again. Aris, Villarreal. Playing forward, Lassiter, this looks good. Miranda off his line, Lassiter, heavy first touch, cuts it in front, and a foot save by Miranda. It'll come back out. Couldn't get that touch towards goal, unfortunately.
Yeah, just that extra touch a little heavy and made that angle much too acute for him to capitalize, making the save a little bit routine, but this is what Lassiter can do. He can get in behind and make life very difficult.
Play on to the left side now. Here's the cross into the area intended for Slager. He'll run it down. Diallo doing a good job of staying on him here. Not getting any help from Covarrubias. I thought he'd come there to close him down, but nonetheless, it's going to be a throw-in here for the Galaxy. Look at it again.
Yeah, and here's that heavy touch. Great foot save, you have to say, in this center of goal here from OC. But moments ago, you saw Diallo much better defending, closing down the space and limiting the opportunities from this Orange County right-hand side.
Here's Steris. Trying to find McBean with that long searching ball. It'll be cleared out. It'll come out the near side now. Slager. Taking off the ball. Diallo able to hop his defender. Now get the cross into the area over the top of Jack. Lassiter to run it down to keep it in play. And no, this will find the touchline and a throw-in.
The idea is there. It's much better. You just need more in terms of execution from Diallo. But the approach is the right idea. You want to get out, stretch, get the ball wide, stretch those central defenders, open up those gaps for the likes of McBean and Bowen to get ahead on it.
Well, a lot more patient now in their play. A lot more calm in their play. They've turned the tide to be able to get numbers forward now.
That's been a real positive response since that early goal from Orange County. Kurt Anolfo has to be pleased with that after a bit of a, let's be honest, slightly lethargic start that lacked a bit of energy.
Here's Romney. Back out, Aris. Tried to find Bowen, too heavy on that pass. OC will come out with possession. For a moment, that is. Good work on the part of Villarreal getting it back. Aris up the left side. He'll find McBean. McBean chopped down. That's a foul and a free kick for the Galaxy.
And it's going to be a card as well, Joe. Real crunching tackle. Griffiths doesn't like it, and he appeared that he had won the ball. We'll have to take a closer look at it, but McBean certainly paid the price. But they're starting to find success, get a little bit of joy down that left-hand side.
McBean helped to his feet. He's going to be all right. Took a pretty good shot there. The referee felt it was a foul and a yellow card.
Now he's a big, strong boy. He's taking a lot worse. Let's take a look at it here. He does win the ball. Does catch McBean, though, with that trailing left foot. And that's the appeal. That's the grounds for the appeal from Griffiths that he'd have to say, in all objectivity, that he does have a case there. Nevertheless, referee doesn't see it that way, and now the Galaxy with a golden opportunity to draw level.
This will keep the goalkeeper on his line. Here's Aris on his right foot. He's got Diallo on the front post. He's got Steris right in the middle. Backside, Bowen. Aris tries to go towards goal and knocked away. McBean, he'll run this one down, back into midfield. Pierres, a good job getting on that cross for OC. Lassiter will let it go for Bowen. Surprised them a bit. Cleared back into midfield. They'll look for the quick counter, but the Galaxy do a good job of getting numbers back. Villarreal able to win it back here for the Galaxy. He'll find Bowen. It'll come left side. Diallo. Able to run past his defender for a moment. Good job that time by Jeffrey Pieras. He'll have it on the near side. Cortez. And again, Galaxy on possession. 1-2 passes back to the men in white. Starting to tilt towards the OC goal. Here's Diallo. Early ball. This is easy for Miranda.
You want to see a little bit better decision making from Diallo in those attacking positions from him. Took an extra touch a moment ago. Next time he plays it early. You like to see the variation there, but he's got to pick those right moments to do that. He didn't have the support there inside the area. Overhit it just a bit. Just trying to fine-tune things.
A little more confidence in the ball because I think he has the talent to beat Pieras, especially with the amount of green he has in front of him. He had options of going inside or outside, but got that early cross away. And as you said, Christian, not enough white shirts up there to help him out. Here it comes on the near side now, Slonger. Nice job by Romney closing it down. Back to Diop.
Excellent defending from the big, strong, athletic Romney. Has such a great understanding back there. Knows when to cover for his fullback. Knows when to step and when to withdraw. That's what you want, though, out of a center back, because 95% of that, playing that position, is cerebral. It's mental. Knowing when to make those right decisions. Putting yourself into a good spot to make the biggest difference that you possibly can. That comes down to reading the game. And
yes,
that's what he does so well for me.
OC on possession here on this throw-in with the lead. 1-0 in the 29th minute with Christian Miles, Joe Tutino. Thank you for joining us here tonight here at LAGalaxy.com. Galaxy home, LA Galaxy 2, that is, our home against the OC Blues on this evening. Steris. Back to Diop. Romney now. He'll take up some space, now launch forward, trying to find Bowen. It'll come in towards center via Real. Can't get on the end of it, however, kept alive by the Galaxy. Aris finds McBean. And a throw-in. Not enough touches, I would say, at this point for Ariel Lasseter. We'll get to that. Train like a champion at LA Galaxy Summer Camps, driven by Chevy. Check out lagalaxy.com/camps for a full schedule of dates and locations. Christian, how do you get Lasseter more involved?
Well, what you want to do is play it forward and have that good understanding between he and Franco, but then a lot of that responsibility falls to the likes of Oris as well as Covarrubias. But Lasseter has to drop back. He's got to show and make himself available. Also with McBean, he's coming out into these wider roles. You want Jack McBean in that box, close to that six-yard area, and making that goalkeeper very nervous as he awaits service from players like possibly Lasseter or Villarreal. It's an interesting story with McBean. He's got that big, strong frame. You want to see him utilize that to the best of his abilities.
Here's Romney on the near side. Half hour into this one, Galaxy looking to equalize. Steris. It'll come up the right side. Here's Lasseter. Working on Suggs. He's got a second defender in to help him out. Lasseter along the end line. Gets the cross away. The opportunity scores! Offside, actually. Offside is going to be called against Bowen. Unfortunately, if he doesn't touch that, the Galaxy have the equalizer, but he's in an offside position at the time of that touch, and the linesman put the flag up. They'll talk about it, though.
I'm afraid it's going to be useless, but here's a great run from Lasseter, but what a cross right here. And if Bowen just lets that go, the question is it going to go in? And Bowen, using his instincts right there, getting a hold of it, but had drifted into that offside position. All credit to the referee's assistant. Correct call made.
Yeah, they're still discussing it right now. And it is offside after all. Possession to the OC Blues. Galaxy do not get on the scoreboard. And unfortunately, Bowen, if he doesn't touch it, from my angle, it looked like that was finding the back of the net. Unfortunately for the Galaxy this time.
Well, a little bit of a discussion going on with the referee's assistant there. Tough to see who the booking was against. A lot of dissent from LA. Thought they'd equalize, but applaud the endeavor, the idea, and what a run from Lasseter. We were just talking about how important he is. He makes this team go down the right-hand side, but what was more impressive than that run was that delivery, spot on. And that's what you want. We need more of that from And LA needs more of that from Ariel Lasseter.
Romney stood up, but the Galaxy do get a throw-in out of this. Yeah, more touches from Lasseter will unlock that defense, create more opportunities for the two forwards, as we were talking, trying to find McBean, Bowen. In this case, Villarreal was on the backside.
I make no bones about it, though. This OC Blues outfit has been very well organized, tough to break down, a testament to their setup. Got a nice shape about them. Two big, strong boys up top.
This will come back defensively. The best sequence they've had in quite some time. Pajares. He'll find Slager. Diallo staying with him. Slager keeping on possession there. Back out it comes. Krizanen switches over. Left side. Suggs. Watched there by Lasseter. It'll come back defensively. One more time. Here's Griffiths. Tries to knock it forward. Diallo able to get in front of that one. Villarreal back to Romney. You'll find Jack McBean, who's wrapped up. Look at it one more time on the replay here, Christian.
Ooh, he might have been played on by the left back.
It's
and
possible
that's
at the time of the touch.
Tough to tell from that angle.
At the time of the touch, he might have been on.
The OC Blues left back. Tough to tell, though, and be absolutely certain. The referee's assistant had the best view of it.
Here's McBean. Could not get that shot away.
Initially, I thought it was offside, Joe, hands down, but a little closer than it initially appeared. LA may have grounds for complaint here, and the foul comes in. But also, too, you've got to be pleased with it going forward. But in the back, they've plugged all the holes. They found the seams. LA not giving any space and making life very difficult in their defensive half as OC looks to come forward. Haven't given up much.
Here's Slager. Back out, Pajares. And this will turn out to be possession back for the Galaxy as Pajares ran out of ideas there. So a throw-in here, 35 minutes in.
You have to give credit to the game plan here from Los Dos. Their cage was rattled early. It wasn't the best start, but they kept the same philosophy. No real changes. That high line, still playing high as usual, and we've seen a lot of that this season from Los Dos. Fortunately, though, for them, very much on the same page, making life very, very tough for this OC Blues team that trying to make their own adjustments here.
Galaxy fans want to win a brand new 2015 Chevrolet Colorado. Well, visit LAGalaxy.com/Chevy to see some of your favorite players in action and to enter for a chance to win. Good luck. Here's Pajares. Bad touch allows the Galaxy to get it back. Bowen now. He has a little space. You'll find Jack McBean ahead, able to get away from the defender for a moment. Now Lasseter on that left foot. It's blocked. It'll come out to Covarrubias. He's got Franco on the right if he wants him. He'll decide to send it into the area. It comes out this time for Bowen. Not a good pass for Aris that time. That needed to be a little more square. Now Steris. Squares over to Romney. Again, Steris. One more time for the Galaxy. Aris checking back. We'll have it. Be confident on the ball. Take up the space, I think, if you're Romney at this point.
Well, if they're going to give him that room to run forward, why not take it? No one closing down, but we're seeing a team that came out high and pressing early on before the goal. They're content very much to sit back and absorb this pressure. They've looked comfortable in patches.
It's going to be a dangerous play against Villarreal.
Petrijevic there almost meeting the lace and leather of Villarreal. Lucky boy. I think, though, if you're Cardinalfo, and you want more of the same here for the last 10 minutes or so, get into halftime, even if you don't manage to find that equalizing goal. It's been positive play. It's been tighter, but they're holding their shape better. There's a better understanding in the back. They're probing and finding those places in attack. What you'd like to see more and more of, though, is a little bit better on the counter and you want to see better play on the wings as well. And when we've seen that, it's reaped positive dividends with the likes of Lassiter and even McBean, as well as Diallo storming forward here on the left.
Here's Bowen now for the Galaxy. Stood up by his defender. He'll have to play it back out. Aris will try to wheel it around to that left side. Here's McBean on the first touch, able to play it back. Diallo and McBean able to keep it in play. Now on his right foot, Jack has a go at goal at the near post. This is an easy save for Pepe Miranda.
Ambitious, to say the least, from Jack McBean, who is not lacking in confidence, scoring a big goal on Saturday night against the Sacramento Republic. Why not? He's feeling it, but you'd like to see a little bit better quality chance and a better angle, a little closer to goal for Los Dos. It's always that elusive final product that is always hard to come by.
Well, this also comes out, those type of shots usually come out of frustration. You've been tangled up for much of the half. You finally have some space in front of you. You're going to give it a go. Didn't quite hit it the way you wanted to.
You want to see McBean, though, a little closer to goal where you can present more danger and let Diallo roam forward and provide the attacking width.
Here's Crittenden playing on that left side. Suggs making the late run. He'll have it on the left side. Franco, he'll come back defensively. The cross into the Galaxy penalty area. Comes out to the top of the box. The ball at goal over the bar and out of play from Papara. And a goal kick here for Clément Diop.
He'll wish he had that one back. A couple of good looks here we've seen in the first half from Orange County, aside from the goal, but too much space down the left-hand side. You'd like to see Joe Franco close that down a little bit better and limit the service.
McBean does a good job, able to get this one forward. He'll find Villarreal. Shakes one defender, tries to play this one through. It comes out for Lassiter, runs in on the keeper, makes the save, the second opportunity, and we're level at a goal apiece. Ariel Lassiter with the goal here in the 40th minute.
Deserved goal, persistence finally pays off. It wasn't exactly as they drew it up. Right place at the right time for Ariel Lassiter, who did a good job of sticking with it. Goalkeeper in no man's land, comes way off his line. He's got to make a better clean save. Lassiter, a player of his quality, is going to gobble that one up each and every time. Not the prettiest of goals, but good enough for his ninth. LA Galaxy 2 will take it any way they can get it right now. A deserved goal. And we've got ourselves a ball game here, Mr. Titino.
Yes, sir. And now you'll see how the OC Blues, if they respond, how will they respond? Because over the last 20, 25 minutes, it has been the Galaxy with the better of the play. Here it comes near side, though. Crittenden plays it into the six, and easy this time for Clément Diop.
Almost living up to the old cliche, or very vulnerable when you've just after you've had your best success.
Hey, stay up to date on all things USL by following the USL on Facebook and Twitter, or check out USLsoccer.com for scores, stats, news, and more.
Second ball's so, so important, and it was Lassiter able to pick up the scraps there. We'll see what kind of a response Orange County has here.
This ball in the head for Slager. Diallo will allow it to go back to Diop. Slager could have done a better job attacking that ball and giving the Galaxy defense more fits. Diop. Nice job by Jack, able to flick it ahead. It'll come out near side. Papara. Crittenden. Franco does well. And Aris able to settle down for Covarrubias. Here's really McBean, wrong side of him.
That was really good work there from Franco to win it back.
Covarrubias now for the Galaxy. He's got Franco in the channel. Back out to Aris. Good work there by Andre for a moment. He's not going to get that foul called in his favor.
Well, great movement from the Galaxy to switch the point of attack, but he didn't have any targets. No run made to that far right-hand side.
Well, Franco's going to knock the ball back. He's supposed to make that run for Aris to give him the service, right?
And a lot of bodies in the box as well. A little bit congested.
Here's Romney. Finding Villarreal. switching it, looking for Lassiter, the goal scorer here for the Galaxy.
And there you go. Give him a target. Give him something to pass to. That's where you want Lassiter. You got players like Bowen and McBean in the box. Lassiter doesn't need to be in there with them. You want him in a wider role. We saw the danger it provided earlier in the first half with that ball whipped in. He can pick up those second balls.
Yep.
Let the tall timber do the work. He can pick up the scraps, pick up the heaps, and as you've seen, take the plaudits as well.
Here's Blanco. Plays in towards center. Good job by Villarreal winning it back. However, the pass could have been better. Papara. Covarrubias will get the foul. He might get a yellow out of this.
Yeah, it's a little cynical from Covarrubias, and he's not going to protest it too much. Takes his card, takes his punishment, but you'd have to say a tactical foul here,
yes,
stopping this Orange County counterattack. It wasn't too dire, though, for Los Dos. They had tracked back nicely.
Had
good
numbers,
solid
yeah.
line.
It's a good restart here as we approach halftime, 44th minute, even at a goal apiece. OC Blues opened up the scoring on the goal by Cortez. Galaxy thought they had tied it up, but they were offside, according to the linesman. Then Lassiter did tie it up at 1-1. That's where we stand right now. Referee gives the go-ahead. Here's the restart. Lobbed into the Galaxy defense. Good job by Romney. Able to clear it out of the box. Crittenden will go left side. Blanco and a throw for the Galaxy.
Very, very well defended from a dead ball situation. You couldn't ask for anything better. Los Dos seem to be growing as this game progresses. The confidence you can see in this back line. They're trusting each other. It wasn't there in the first 15 minutes. It is there right now.
It's kind of been the theme of these 13 games for the Galaxy. A little slow start, but then they find the rhythm, take over control. They'll get a foul here in their favor. Covarrubias was knocked by Cortez.
And you give up 18 goals in 18 games. You're doing something right,
yep,
in the back.
Aris. It'll come back out. Steres. Romney. Diallo under some pressure. Good decision to go all the way back to his goalkeeper, Diop. Now Steres will work it towards the right side. He's got Aris showing. He'll go right side here for Blanco, or I should say Franco, and he can't keep it in play. Too hot on that pass. Navarro. Switched over to Griffiths. Cortez tries to send it forward. It's broken up. He'll get another chance at it. Crittenden. Good job by Steres. Nice job by Steres there. 1 minute of added time coming here before we get to the break.
That's excellent defending, you said it, Joe, for Daniel Steres. Franco caught out of position. The kind of coverage that we've seen from Romney providing it for Diallo at times, especially early on. There you see an example of it from Steres. No slouch in his own right. And that's what I was talking about with that trust, that understanding that only comes from playing many, many games
mm-hmm.
together. Stability, one wise man said, is the cornerstone for success. That's what we're seeing right now.
Here's Romney. Right in front of halftime here. Steres once again. Lassiter is working the near side this time. Back out to Covarrubias. Our referee points to midfield, and that is the end of 45 minutes of play. Could have been two goals, but 1-1 for the Galaxy going into the break, and not all bad.
Not the best of starts, but what a recovery. Managed to put together great spells of possession, a disallowed goal. Not only Galaxy, though, positive first half. Have to say, on the balance, been the better team. A little bit hard done by, perhaps, on a disallowed goal, but all in all, I think Kurt Onalfo will be happy with the way things corrected themselves as this match progressed. You look for more of that coming up in a very interesting second half.
Chris Cortez scores for the OC Blues. Ari Lassiter for LA Galaxy. We are 1-1 at the half. Stay with us.
Magical work of Messi again, setting up Neymar! Luis Suarez finishes the job once and for all, and he made it look so simple.
I mean, it was amazing. It was, one of those games definitely where, you kind of realize it's, you put it in perspective and you see that it's bigger than just a sport. You know, there's millions of kids that struggle in the world with who they are, regardless if they're gay or straight or, different religions and ethnicities and all that stuff. So to be kind of a bit of a spokesperson for just being different, I guess. I realized that game was kind of a symbol in that way. I wasn't ready to play. I wasn't really fit or hadn't trained for a long time. But I was really excited and I felt grateful to be able to get onto the field and kind of start my career and have my family there. And obviously my teammates were very supportive and the stadium. I mean, I think you've heard this before. Is when you go into a stadium, you usually don't hear people or notice what's going on in the stands, but I remember just a little bit more excitement and people, getting up and applauding and just being supportive. So it was a pretty special moment. Special also when I hear from other people how important that moment was for them, and they say, like, I watched your first game, or I was in the stadium, and like, I'd never been to a Galaxy game, but I came to the stadium to support you that day. I remember on my way to the game, like, oh, wow, like, this is going to be, my first time being back, and, I wasn't sure if I was going to play or not, so I was just thinking of the possibilities. But it's more I look back now and kind of see, my first game back and kind of the journey I went through for the next few years, a couple of years, and then winning a championship last year. And I think that's why I was like overly emotional after we won, because I remembered all those experiences. And again, the ups and downs and, hard road trips and tough training sessions and bad games and good games. And that was definitely, the beginning. So I remembered all that stuff. It's crazy. It's been 2 years. It feels like it's been a lot longer than that, but I think some of the biggest changes I think would just be more just enjoying every day coming in here and kind of being at peace with who I am and how I am different from guys on the team, but also how I've been able to fit in and just to kind of transition into being just another member on our team and to be a soccer player or Robbie instead of rather than, being a gay soccer player. When I first came in, it was tough to always do, media every day or have different events or different things where it was just so, there was so much focus on me being a gay athlete. And now I don't really even think about it. So I think that's the biggest difference.
That's the moment of the game. Alan Gordon, nice header there. clearly he's happy because it was an important victory, especially as they await the arrival of Steven Gerrard. They want to get the momentum going.
It was the Los Angeles Galaxy beating the Houston Dynamo 1-0. Don't have a good night. Have a great night.
Taken off the ball by Walker. He's able to play it forward and land at Donovan. Donovan finding Robbie Keane. This looks good. Keane tries to cut it back. Landon Donovan has set the record. 135 goals. And that is the new mark in Major League Soccer. 2-0 Galaxy.
There is no better way for that goal to have come. Much deserved. Sends the message that he's needed.
Congratulations to Landon Donovan, because this is just a great ball that he puts in. Continues the run, and as the ball goes across, he makes sure that he is in the space and can finish this off. Brilliant goal all the way around. And Landon Donovan right there makes history. As you can see, the joy right there, what that goal means.
It's been a long week. And you have no idea how many messages I've received from people, literally thousands of messages from people around the country, around the world. People that say, I'm a diehard Sounders fan, I'm a diehard DC United fan, I've hated you all of my life on the field, and you know, I'm so happy for you. And I think you guys know me pretty well. It's hard not to make it about me. And I don't necessarily want it to be that way, but you know, I've sacrificed a lot to be in the position I'm in, and I was very happy for myself because I've dedicated a lot to this, and I really think I deserve what happened today. Mm-hmm. To be honest, when I scored, I wasn't thinking about the record. It only occurred to me maybe 10 seconds into the celebrating, and it's great. I mean, it really is. But I think more importantly, I want to make sure that I enjoy the rest of the season. I keep helping our team, and I want to get back to enjoying football, because this has been a week where I had moments where I fell out of love with it a little bit, and I want to make sure that I keep enjoying it.
Is your wall in need of some signed memorabilia? Now you can bid on the LA Galaxy Foundation Silent Auction without leaving your seat. All you have to do is text GALAXY to 52182. Start bidding and you can win the shirt right off my...
Shut this down. very special for me. You know, I haven't spent too much time in LA, but you know, it's great to come into such a good team. You know, we've got a lot of good players, and you know, it was tough leaving, but you know, it just came around that time to you know, just expand my wings and get some playing time. And despite everything, I had a really good time at West Ham. You know, I spent a long time, and I learned a lot. I wouldn't be the player that I am today if it wasn't for that club. So I have a lot of respect for them. But it, you know, like I said, it wasn't easy leaving. But I'm happy I'm here. I'd like to say I'm you know, more of on the creative side. I've tried to, you know, play attacking midfield. Luckily, I can play out wide, or I can play in the middle. And I think it'll just vary. I think it just depends on what formation and how the manager sees it. But I think we'll just take it day by day and see where I fit in. You know, try to create stuff and try to get some goals.
And we welcome you back to the Track and Field Stadium at StubHub Center alongside Christian Miles, Joe Tutino. Happy to have you along here on the broadcast tonight. Galaxy 1, OC Blues 1. No substitutions here to start the second 45, none expected. Galaxy to defend the goal to our left, then attack from left to right. The second half is underway, and it'll come out near side to Ari Lassiter, who scored the goal for the Galaxy in the first half. Franco. It'll come back to Daniel Starez. All the way back to Clément Diop. Here's Starez.
Now, Joe, I'm sure Cardinalfa will want more of the same in the way LA Galaxy finished the first half.
Right.
They want to start the second half. So we'll see how it goes. No changes for either team. The same 22 we saw take the pitch at the beginning. A lot of adjustments, I'm sure, that Orange County want to make. They haven't been dangerous enough.
Ball will come out near side. McBean trying to run it down. Good job here by Jack. This will be a throw-in for the Galaxy. Covarrubias to take this throw-in. Actually lets it go for Joe Franco. Here's Aris. Able to knock it into the area. Come out near side, Blanco this time. Franco pressuring. Jack McBean will win it back. Good move here by the Galaxy. It'll come back out. Covarrubias once again. Thought he could have made that run to goal. It'll come out one more time. Aris with a big rainbow into the area. And knocked away. Here's Diallo. On that far side. Trying to get away from Slogger. Again, Covarrubias. Aris one more time. Romney. Nice job by Diallo again, shaking the defender. This is dangerous. They'll get the throw-in. OC Blues will get the throw-in out of it.
Positive start here from Los Dos, keeping the pressure on, pushing Orange County very deep back in their defensive third, looking for that mistake, trying to impose their will on this game. You know, 99% of this game, they say it's simple, but 99% of it is mental right now.
All the games are simple. They're all kids' games. but it does get difficult as you go up a level or two, right?
But they've trying to continue that intensity, and we saw it progress in the first half. Looks as though it is continuing here at the start of the second. The question is for Orange County right now, that can they sustain? They've been very balanced in the back. They've been able to absorb a lot of this LA Galaxy pressure in stretches. There's been some inconsistency in that regard. It's up to them to weather that storm. You're away from home. You played over the weekend. It's not an easy task.
Here's a ball over the top on the right side, offside.
I think it was Crittenden just behind. We see this tackle moments ago. You talk about coming in full-blooded. That is a thunderous tackle from Diallo, who's really grown with this game. There's more to his game, individually speaking, than just going forward. Likes the tackle.
Yeah, Miranda able to pick up here. And one of the things going back to OC Blues, they had that one pass over the top that led to the goal, the Cortez goal. And the Galaxy have done a good job taking away that option for them. Getting over the top and down the middle of the park and then forcing them to go wide, and the Galaxy are doing a good job defensively of taking away those lanes. Few and far between have they been able to get a good crossaway.
And we've been praising the likes of Romney and Steris in the back, but a lot of the credit has to go to that partnership of Aris and Covarrubias. They put their foot down in this midfield. Crittenden has been non-existent, barely touched the ball in this game.
McBean brought down. That'll be a foul and a free kick. Griffiths got a hold of him. He's playing on a yellow card, by the way. Griffiths. It's a good restart opportunity now for the Galaxy. It'll be just about 30 yards from goal. And you got guys who can knock it from there. Covarrubias, Aris.
Aris has been feeling it as of late. We mentioned he scored one recently, a thing of beauty, and has a good understanding here with Lassiter, but more importantly, this is the bread and butter for Los Dos. They've got the tools. Can they use them is the question.
Here's Aris. Got a little bit too much of that one over the bar and out of play.
Well, it hasn't been his A game,
no.
Has it tonight, Joe? We saw him flub one from a free kick situation earlier in the first half. A couple of corners that have been squibbed a bit. I'm sure he'll want to have that one back.
Hey, looking to spend a night out with the family? Galaxy Family 4-packs get you 4 tickets, hot dogs, drinks, and scarves for just $112. Purchase yours today at LAGalaxy.com. Restart here for the OC Blues. 51st minute of this one, tied at a goal apiece. A victory tonight for the Galaxy, and they take over first place in the West. OC trying to improve upon their playoff position.
You see that long direct ball, and that really going back to the success that you were discussing a moment ago that the Blues had early on in the first half. Probably see them go more direct. That's where they've been at their best.
Here's Lassiter. He'll win the corner. Good work there, Bahari.
Bags and bags of confidence comes from a pretty rich talent pool, as you would say.
Yes.
Some good genes. Those of you in the soccer world know the Lassiter family, but certainly Ariel continuing that rich tradition of attacking prowess. You see his confidence growing with this game as well. Let's see what we can get from Orris here. It's got to be better.
Here's Orris. He'll go backside one more time. Diallo does get on the first ball. It'll bounce down in front and then clear it away. Not a horrible corner kick if that one's down a little bit more. A foot or so gives Diallo a better chance on that ball.
You know, far post, it did meet its target. Lacked a little bit of whip, a little bit of pace. Like to see it a little bit flatter.
Right.
Still time. Early days here in the second half. What you like, though, is the way Los Dos have been able to dictate. They're playing this game at their pace, at their tempo, at their will.
Orris fouled, free kick. A lot of one-offs here right now for OC. Covarrubias, the quick restart. He'll find Romney. Has plenty of real estate ahead of him. He's got Diallo if he wants him. Orris this time. Under some pressure. Back to Steris. Romney once again. He'll knock it forward. Bowen. McBean tried to square it in for Covarrubias. And that'll be cleared out. Here's Navarro for OC. Nice job by Franco. Gets in front of the pass. He'll end up finding Covarrubias. Could be a little crisper there. The Galaxy able to clear again forward. And now a bit sloppy by both sides right now. Kretinen able to play it back. Navarro all the way back to his keeper, Miranda, and they'll reset.
You know, one fact you have to consider from the Orange County perspective, these guys have been on the road. I mean, this is their fourth consecutive away game. We talked about the woes they've had, but that's got to take its toll mentally and physically on you. You play so many games away from your home fans, all that home support that can be very much reinvigorating.
Orris with a couple of chances here to take it in on goal, unfortunately could not find the handle. Turns out to be a goal kick.
So far, so good, though, for Curtinolfo and Los Dos in charge, in command. Need to see it translated. A few more quality chances, however.
I would imagine the next 10, 15 minutes, we'll start seeing the first of the subs from Curtinolfo's bench. Talked about Kanoa Bailey, a lot of speed if he's able to get onto the field. I imagine we will see Bradford Jamison in this match as well.
A lot of firepower on the bench tonight for Los Dos. Crittenden desperate to get involved, wearing the number 21 in blue. He's dropping in wider positions, trying to show. Just hasn't been able to get a foot in the game. And good play from Shugs here.
It's be a throw-in. OC on that throw. Blanco back out. Suggs able to play it back. Navarro, he'll wheel it around his defense. Find Griffiths, lobs it into the Galaxy defense. Good job there by Romney, able to clear it forward. Villarreal cleans it up ahead to Bowen. Travis getting away from one defender. He'll find Jack McBean, who finds some space here on the right channel. Closed down now by one defender. Gets the cross to the back post, a bit long and out of play for a goal kick. Nice build up though.
Good counterattacking move there from Los Dos. McBean had about 60 yards to cover. All credit, he did cover it well. But Lassiter taking his role in that central point position up top, looking for the support on the right-hand side. A bit of a role reversal for those two. Perhaps a little experimenting going on with the LA Galaxy 2 attack. But we've seen a lot of that from McBean. That's what he's been prone to do, floating out into those wide areas.
Here's Miranda, that ball. A little miscommunication there between McBean and Lassiter. Everybody goes back to their regular positions now.
Yeah,
I think you're asking a bit much, though, on that ball from Lassiter to McBean.
This is an OC Blues team. They need some fresh ideas right now. It's gone stale for them. The long direct flick on just doesn't seem to be working. It has given you a few positive moments, but nothing of consistent consequence. Hasn't really struck fear into the hearts of this Los Dos defense.
And one of the things for them, and we talked about it, you're talking about Crittenden trying to get into the play, is they haven't had enough to pull those center backs forward to really get the ball over the top and be dangerous. Even the long ball coming over the top, center backs are able to play center field, so to speak, and not get split. This one, though, does look good as they're able to move it forward. The pass, not a good one, right into Franco's stride, and the Galaxy come out.
And just when you think they're going to break through, it all goes wrong.
Lassiter, unfortunately, runs past this one. Petrichevic able to play it back. Blanco this time. For Cortez, behind him on the wrong side, and Romney easy. He'll collect it. I mean, it is a 4-5-1 for OC. We know exactly what they're doing.
And we've seen Cortez at the tip of the spear, so to speak. Papara coming in behind, and this is going to be an easy call, the free kick, and we're going to see a little bit of yellow as well.
R is still slow to get up here. Yellow card. Petrichevic. Turn that yellow.
Yeah, tough to argue against that one. Clear-cut case. But dead balls haven't exactly been successful tonight. A lot of that has come down to Aris. Yeah, really not to beat a dead horse, but you want to see a better trajectory, a little bit more velocity on his delivery. We know he's got the pedigree. We know he can do it. Let's see if he can prove it.
Got enough space here to really send one of his missiles into the area. Now sends it towards goal onto the top of the six. That was much better and cleared away. This will be a throw-in for the Galaxy.
You said it, Joe. Better, better. And when you get that good delivery, it opens up all kinds of chances, not just on the initial ball, but on that second ball as well.
Here's Romney. Bowen. Covarrubias. He'll lob this one into the 18. Jack can't get on the end of it, but a second chance from Bowen, and it's wide of the near side. Goal kick.
Audacious there from Bowen, but it gives you an idea of the confidence he has in his own abilities. He gets got full contact, hit it flush, good wood on it, but it just lacked a bit of accuracy. You know, as a striker, you play the game, you see those balls, and they sit up like that. They take that bounce.
I think Travis was hoping that ball would flatten out a little bit more for him. It got him a little bit high.
He was licking his lips and his eyes got wide. Had the highlight reel in mind, that's for sure.
Sure. Lassiter. He'll knock this one ahead, intended for Villarreal. Looks like we'll see Bradford Jameson in a moment. Puts on the jersey, getting some nice shot here by Villarreal is blocked in front and cleared away. Lassiter getting some final instructions from Kurt Onolfo.
Great movement there from Villarreal. And that's what we want to see more of, especially down that left-hand side. He's got great technical ability, and he can cause all kinds of fits for defenders. And this change will be very interesting. Well, and that was going to be the last kick of the game for Villarreal. So what you give up in technical ability, you gain bags and bags of speed and pace. With Bradford Jameson, we've seen him at the senior team level. We've seen him do the business here at the USL level as well. The game in the balance, the perfect situation for him. His team is on top of this game. They have the confidence. If he can utilize his athletic ability and his nose for goal, positive stuff lies ahead for Los Dos.
Here is Jameson, and he will get a foul called against him. Tried to post up on the player in front. Looked like he might have been dragged down, but no, as Jeffrey Pajares is fouled by Jamison. And Bradford Jamison here getting a discussion from our referee. Add a yellow card immediately.
Interesting.
See the future of the Galaxy when Raul Mendiola, Oscar Soto, and Los Dos take on Arizona United Sunday, August 9th, 4 o'clock at StubHub Center. Tickets are only $10 at LAGalaxy.com, and kids 12 and under get in free. You're saying, Christian?
Well, inauspicious start to the game for Bradford Jamison. Not even 30 seconds on the pitch and finds himself in the referee's books. Not privy to what he might have uttered to the match official. Nevertheless, it didn't work out too well for the LA Galaxy sub. Interesting, though, in the attack, and you look at the weapons. You've got Lassiter on the right.
Long ball into the area. Nice job by Steris. It'll come ahead to Jack, and he's pushed, and he'll get that foul. I thought that was a dangerous move on the part of McBean, letting that ball drop. Here's Lassiter now, trying to turn on the Jets to get away from Suggs. It'll be cleared out of play over the near side touch. Good work defensively that time by the Blues. Throwing, though, Galaxy.
And as I was saying, you've got Lassiter on the right, and you expect to see Jamison take up a role on the left-hand side, and Bowen and McBean, they will swap roles in the center. Anolfo has gone in search of goals, that's for sure. The question is, will they arrive?
Petrčević able to play it over to the right side of the circle. It'll come forward here for Popera. Right side, Slogger taking off the ball. Throwing, though, in favor of the Blues. The question, though, is you have Lassiter on the right and you have a clear on the other side of the field, Bradford Jamison. They're not going to be able to combine unless one decides to leave their position and come in towards the center of the park.
What you've got, though, Joe, is pace.
Yes.
And you want that in those positions. More importantly, though, it'll allow Jack McBean to take up a role in the center of the attack. And it will give both Lassiter as well as Jamison a target.
Griffith's able to go forward. He'll find Papara. Good work there on the part of Aras. Strips into the ball and then earns the foul and a free kick.
Frustration, you'd have to say, there from Popar. Knows he should have done better in that situation. Has his pocket picked. So Orris is able to show off the full repertoire in his individual game. He's not all about spraying passes around. He can get into a tackle or two as well.
Here's Franco. Has a little trouble with it. Can't find the handle on the pass. It's cleared away. Watch out for the counterattack. Here comes Kretinen. Into the channel on the left side, it goes for Suggs. He sends it towards goal, and it's boxed away by the goalkeeper, Diop. Corner kick. That was flighted towards that backside.
Yeah, lightning cat-quick counterattack here from Orange County Blues. It all starts with Franco getting caught out of position, opens up a huge hole down this left-hand side, and Suggs, he's done well defensively, but utilizes his pace and perhaps a little bit ahead of the attacking support. But that's positive play from the Blues, trying to hit against the run of play.
Here's the corner for OC. Right-footed ball that'll bend away from the keeper, back down towards the spot, knocked out by Diallo. Second chance here, though. Popera tries to send it through. It'll be blocked and out the near side. Here's Slogger. We have a player down for OC. Ball out of play, and a throw-in for Orange County. But we'll take a look at the injured player for now.
It looks to be Crittenden right about now. Not sure exactly how it transpired, but he's writhing in pain. It's not Crittenden, rather. It's Papara who took his licks there.
Here comes the trainer to take a look. Hopefully not too bad of an injury. Seems like he's now sitting up.
He's been playing in a supporting attacking role just behind the likes of Cortez, just in front of Crittenden.
Mm-hmm.
Like to see him find more of a link between those two players. That's been part of the reason this OC attack has stagnated just a bit. We've seen signs of life, though, in the last two or three minutes, however.
You know, Christian, you were talking about the fact that the Galaxy now have tremendous speed and talent on the wings. My question to you is now, is it Aris combining with one, whether it's Jameson on the left and Covarrubias with the responsibility of being that third party on the right side with Lassiter going forward?
Well, I think what you want to see is Aris obviously in that ball-winning responsibility position, but Covarrubias has shown a great knack of finding the attacking, linking play. And we've got players like Lassiter, and you've got Jameson, who's got those fresh legs coming off the bench. It's more of a question of, hey, you want Aris to get the ball back. You need the possession to start things off. If he can find a link either to Covarrubias or spray it long himself, it's going to lead to more positive play.
Play will continue on the throw-in. Suggs into the area. It's cleared to the top of the box, and Covarrubias able to get it out of harm's way. Here's Griffiths now for OC. It'll come back, Navarro. Up the near side and out of play. That was an easy one for the Galaxy here on the throw.
Yeah, Los Dos have done a great job defensively of squeezing the park here throughout this game. That's how much confidence they have in that back line, almost daring them to go over the top with Cortez, because that's the confidence they have in the likes of Romney as well as Steris.
Here's Bradford Jameson. Aris this time tries to power it ahead for Ariel Lassiter. That's cleared away.
Doesn't need to pick the long pass each and every time.
He's thinking the same thing right there.
Sometimes you just want to keep it simple.
This will be a foul against Aris and a good restart opportunity now for the OC Blues.
And that's frustration from Aris. He knows he picked the wrong pass, and he was the culprit there, is put his teammates into a vulnerable situation, wanted to recover, wanted to atone. Fortunately, doesn't come away with a booking. But nevertheless, put him in a little bit of peril here on this dead ball, unnecessarily so. We haven't seen a lot of danger here from these types of situations from the Blues. We'll see what's in store.
Well, the Galaxy do have some height defensively to defend on plays like this.
Yeah, they look so comfortable, Joe, defending these types of situations.
Our referee gives the go-ahead here. Well, apparently not. Now he will. Nice job by Steris, able to clear this one out. Another ball from deep by Paparis is blocked and cleared ahead to Ariel Lassiter. A good slide tackle by Blanco to get it back. Navarro. It'll come ahead, Papara. And possession back to the Galaxy. Lassiter. Jack making a run on the near side. He'll wait for some help. Here's Franco. It'll come left side. Diallo this time. He'll take it in. And now fire it wide on the left to Bradford Jameson. Jameson trying to turn the corner on his defender. Able to keep the ball in play, but Miranda will come out.
Situation you want. Jameson isolated in a 1v1 situation. Couldn't get the best of the right back. Good piece of defending.
Here's Papyrus. Pierres, I should say. Good job by Romney getting in front of that pass. Covarrubias. He'll find Aris. The Galaxy restart again.
And that's better for Morris. Get it, win it, and give it. Keep possession. Build something.
Franco on the near side trying to go forward. It's a throw in here for the Galaxy. Don't go for the home run ball every time. Makes it too easy to defend.
He's probably been watching a lot of video of Steven Gerrard as of late.
Yeah.
He makes it look so easy. Yeah. On video, doesn't he, Mr. Gerrard?
I'm going to do what that guy does. Well,
easier said than done.
Not everybody can.
Most can.
Yeah. Here's Crittenden going forward, trying to bomb up the right side with Slager. Does a good job of getting possession here and keeping possession. Back out wide, Crittenden. Pierres.
Excellent positional defending from Diallo. Stem the tide and putting Los Dos in a situation where they can win it back.
Good work here by Jameson. Trying to send it through for Jack. Probably should have gone to the left side there. Never saw Bowen, who was wide open. I think you go to Bowen, and he can still either get the shot or come across to a wide open McBean eventually.
Yeah, OC early on, we're picking on Bradley Diallo. Mm-hmm. Thought that might be a spot a little bit vulnerable, but he tracks back, able to stem that counterattack, sets this one up nicely for Jamison to win it in the center of the park. Unfortunately, that ball for McBean a little bit heavy. Do like to see McBean at that proverbial tip of the spear, so to speak. We've been talking about it throughout the match, but it's clearly where he's the most dangerous.
Red card has been issued here. Second yellow of the game. I believe this is to Griffiths.
This is where he's going to feel hard done by because it was a little bit dubious on his first booking in the first half.
Yellow card issued to our goalkeeper, Miranda, now.
Looks as though that is for dissent. My, oh, my. This is really going to turn this one on its head.
So he picked up his second yellow, and he's out. Now the Galaxy on a man advantage the rest of the way.
And he had a good game.
Yes.
Griffiths was playing a good game. He read it well. He's able to extinguish a lot of the attacking threat down that left-hand side.
Steven Gerrard, Robbie Keane, Omar Gonzalez, Jossie Zardes, and your five-time MLS Cup champion LA Galaxy, presented by Herbalife, take on Clint Dempsey and the Seattle Sounders. Sunday, August 9th, 1 o'clock, in a match presented by El Torito. Tickets are available right now at LAGalaxy.com.
And pretty soon you'll be adding Gio Dos Santos' name to that illustrious list as well. Exciting times.
Going to be quite a summer for the LA Galaxy and into the fall.
Quite a squad.
Yes.
I mean, you have to give full marks to the staff, the front office, to the Los Angeles Galaxy, who have assembled the best assemblage of talent. You'd have to say Major League Soccer right now, probably some of the best we've seen all time.
I think we're seeing the league start to grow up to, you know, they're growing up through the Beckham era and certainly the backside of the Landon Donovan era. And now they're, you know, taking that next step in maturity.
And it's going to force a double switch now for Oliver Vies and the Orange County Blues. It was the right back Griffiths who came off, so they're going to bring on the likes of Ryan Felix. He's the defender. It's probably going to fill that role on the right-hand side. You would expect them probably to go to a 4-4-1. And Cortez, we'll see the role that he's going to play. He's going to be up there on an island by himself. So
continuing on that island.
Mm-hmm. Blanco off.
Here's the restart. Aris sends it through. And he scored. No, off the bar and out. It bounced in front, hit the bar, and stayed out.
See what happens when you have a better delivery? The last two have been absolutely sublime from the Frenchman. It just wreaks havoc, and it's unhinged the confidence of this OC Blues team.
It had looked like Steres had a clean look at getting on the end of it. I believe he missed it. It bounced down in front and then off the bar. Hopefully we'll get the replay here for you in a moment. Here's Aris. Looking at it one more time here. Did bounce down in front. Nobody touched it. And it hit the bar and came out.
Unbelievable, though. But what a delivery from Andre Aris. And we've been critical of him in that situation, in these types of situations throughout the game. But all credit, you got to give credit where credit is due. He is vastly improved. Interesting setup here. Cortez has gone to the left-hand side. Crittenden supporting through the middle in the attack. He's swapping that role with Polpara right now. They're going to have to collapse into a defensive shell. The question is, with 10 men and 15 minutes left, can they absorb this sustained pressure?
Lassiter, Jack McBean back out to Lassiter, tried to go near side, cleared out. Romney to be cleared away. Another long ball up that right side. Out comes Diop. Slager got to that ball first. It's going to turn out to be a goal kick here. I'm not sure why Diop came out so far. Hey, ever want to visit Costa Rica? Alaska Airlines is giving you the chance. Post a photo of yourself in a Galaxy gear on Facebook or Twitter and use the hashtag AcrossTheGalaxy. One winner will be selected for a free trip to Costa Rica. Visit lagalaxy.com/AcrossTheGalaxy. For more information,
pencil me in.
Absolutely. Costa Rica, it's a nice trip.
That's a no-brainer, my friend. So, interesting move there from Diop. Not the best of judgment, you have to say. Coming all the way clear of his penalty area. Defender was back, but he committed early to it. Could have been disastrous for LA Galaxy, too.
He makes the spectacular and sometimes makes the easy turn into spectacular.
And that's what you get with the young goalkeeper at times. Slightly overzealous.
Good work on the left side. Diallo able to get the cross away. OC is going to be able to clear this one again down the middle of the park. Steris. You'll find Covarrubias.
So the interesting move here from Oliver Vese is he's brought in Christopher Ramirez to take up the focal point in the attack, wearing the number 22 in blue. We talked about Cortez being an island by himself. It looks as though that role is going to be handed over to Christopher Ramirez. A bit of a different dimension he'll add to the game. More of a mobile, speedy presence than a big target man in the traditional number 9 role.
Fresh legs, able to run long distances. You're going to knock the ball forward, try to beat down the middle of the park. It's a good move, but ultimately, as you said earlier, Christian, you're asking your team now to defend for 15 minutes in a shell when you haven't had part of the game for, what, 60 minutes of it?
It's all about the point right now, yeah. Joe. You hit the nail on the head, and that's really their best option right now, considering the numerical advantage that Los Dos has. We're going to see some further changes, and it's going to be Christopher Santana coming in. Coming off is going to be Slogger. And this is interesting here. The power of Bowen
right.
going to be replaced by the diminutive presence of Kainoa Bailey, but you know these OC Blue outfit know the power, or excuse me, the pace
yes.
of Kainoa Bailey, having scored the match winner earlier last month down in Orange County.
And Bowen had a quiet second half.
He played his role.
Yep.
He's still trying to find that synchronization with McBean. And this is something you see at Bailey, a guy who can operate under the front two. He can also drift out wide. And we talked about the pace of Lassiter. There's a lot of speed out there for LA Galaxy, too, when you factor in the likes of Jamison and Lassiter. Now throw Bailey into the mix. They're going to try and grind them down.
Here's Franco on the right side. He'll play it back out. Covarrubias. Able to knock it into the area. It's cleared out. Romney to keep it alive. He's got Diallo forward if he wants him. He'll play it top of the box on the bounce. This will be an easy clearance. I think at this point right now for the Galaxy, Christian, it's to be patient when you get into the attack. Because you have the numbers, you have them trying to bunch up around their penalty area, be patient and go with the shorter pass, force that defender to come out, create the lane.
Yeah, I think there's a couple of things that are very important. One, don't get too confident in search of that game winner. And two, exactly have the patience going forward. Find that right ball. Find that right pass. And create the chance that you so desire. Don't settle for a mediocre half opportunity. When you've got the numerical advantage, you've got to make it look like it.
Foul called against McBean in the box.
But it's difficult, Joe.
Yeah.
You've got 10 behind it in front of you. So
oh, yeah.
It's not going to be easy. And not a lot of space out there for this Los Dos attack to go with.
Hey, catch every Galaxy 2 and USL regular season and playoff game live, free, and in HD on YouTube this season. Subscribe today at YouTube/LA Galaxy. 80th minute, we are 1-1 in our match. All the scoring done in the first 45 minutes.
Been impressed, though, although it's been shaky at times for OC. By and large, considering the massive amounts of possession and edge to LA Galaxy 2, this Blues outfit is defended bravely.
Good work here by Ramirez, keeping possession, able to play it forward. Nice job on the part of Diallo. It'll come out left side. Jamison able to play up the wing. Lassiter trying to run this one down. As we take a look at the fisticuff that happened earlier, ball comes near side as we go back to live action. It'll be cleared away.
Game that's had a little bit of everything. Disallowed goal, the sending off. You get the feeling, 10 minutes, there's another big chapter to be written.
Ball will go left side. Diallo. Here's Aris. Another big missile. And this one will go out of play.
Again, it's a ball you don't have to play. A pass that he doesn't have to make. Patient and work it around.
You have, at that point of the time of the pass, wheel it over to the right. You have Franco. You can come back down the wing. Find Kanoa Bailey. They're playing so far deep defensively. With a ball that comes in with pace like that, you're just not going to have enough real estate nor time to catch up to it.
Take what they give you. If they're going to play that deep, play the simple pass. Maybe your teammate will find a better angle. Be patient. Another big change, and we're going to see Ilić come in. Off goes Crittenden. A disappointing day for him by his own lofty standards. I mean, here's a guy that, you know, tops the goal-scoring charts for this OC Blues outfit with 7, along with Ramirez. He's been a focal point of things, and it'll be tough for them to mount anything going forward, but we'll see if change will work out for the better for them.
Aris now for the Galaxy. 82nd minute of this one. Romney. Left side Diallo. He'll find Jameson. Return service here for Diallo, trying to get through his defender, Pajares, who played it well. Pajares still on possession. He earned the foul. Free kick.
These OC defenders, to be applauded, they don't get caught out all that often. Certainly with the defensive posture they have right now, they're not going to be.
Yeah, I don't see any offside traps from these back four.
They were playing a real high line earlier to start the game, similar to Los Dos. But, yeah, they're going to try and ride this one out and take their point. A great exercise here for LA Galaxy 2. And another change. Adrian Vera getting set to come in.
Franco is done. So basically, Kurt Anolfo not realizing, but deciding that, okay, they're going to attack with one. We don't need to defend with four here. We'll defend with three. We'll get some more speed, get some more numbers forward.
Bunker ball.
Yeah.
Can't afford to throw all caution to the wind, however, so they'll leave things a little thin at the back in search of that winner.
Yeah, with three in the back, though, they should be able to handle it. Miranda.
So Vera's going to drop into a midfield role in the center of the park, and Covarrubias reverting to more of a right-sided position.
And you're not going to ask him to go forward too much. In fact, you don't want him to do that. However, here on the steal, it'll go back, and a good chance here for Ramirez keeping possession for OC.
And this is where
Petrichevic,
it's where you can get burned when you gamble like that. And Covarrubias losing out, opening up a huge hole in that right-hand side.
Ball will go right side. Diallo defending there, and he'll get the foul called against him.
Generous call from the referee, in my estimation. A little crowded for space, but it's called playing to the whistle, and it's worked out well here.
Yeah, but you have to know that players are going to flop at this point. You get close to them, they're going to try to, and especially looking at the clock, if you want to get that point away, if that's exactly the goal, maybe steal a goal if you can. Free kick in the offensive third. You got to be careful with that.
And it's more about how they manage this match at this point.
Good restart opportunity here. Two-man wall set up by the Galaxy. 85th minute, tied at a goal apiece. Ball to the backside of the six, and out of play for the goal kick.
I thought he'd overhit it.
Yep.
It looked as though he squibbed that one, but arriving there on that far post was Navarro, who made a great run. It's a big ask of your defender right here, and we look at the situation a moment ago, slightly crowded for space. We've seen them given for less and not given for more.
Grabbed on right in front of the referee. It was an easy call for the referee to make.
More importantly, though, the issue at hand, this is where LA Galaxy 2, considering their past success, this season. The numerical advantage, a point isn't going to be good enough at this point.
Right.
We're going to see, want to see a little bit more.
I agree. OC Blues trying to take as much time off the clock as possible. We can't blame them. Going to be an interesting to see how the Galaxy respond to this right now, and if they can unlock that defense in the final five.
Well, they need to get the ball.
Yeah.
First and foremost right now. This every second that ticks off, the Galaxy are camped in their own defensive half, is positive for Oliver Vies and this Orange County Blue setup.
Another throw in here. Exactly what they want, just keep that clock ticking. Not even looking for that long throw into the area. This one could have been done better. Still possession here, offside though. As the ball went out, I believe it went out of play over the far side touch. This will be a throw.
Good shift out, trying to initiate that counterattack and able to catch the attacker in the offside position. Want to see a little bit more urgency right now.
Steris, he'll start it out here for the Galaxy.
This is that precious game in hand, as they say, against Seattle Sounders,
right,
too. And while 1 point would put them in the first place in the Western Conference, obviously you want three, especially considering the circumstances.
Jamison trying to cut it back here. He's going to get the throwing out of it. Might have been a foul, but the referee didn't see it that way.
He stood him up really well.
Aris plays in just over the top of Bailey. Kept alive here by Romney. Here comes the counter back the other way. Ramirez. The Galaxy look to get some numbers back. Ramirez staying on the ball here. Still taking it down the middle of the park. Gets away from Aris on his right foot. Fakes on the shot. Puts it back on his left. Sends towards goal and out of play.
Sensational from Ramirez. He's really given him that burst of pace, that burst of attacking life. That's what I was talking about earlier. LA Galaxy can't fall in love with looking for that elusive match winner. You leave yourself vulnerable at the back. But a wonderful piece of a counter-attacking football. And you see Ramirez, he held it up, waited for the support to arrive, just found that little pocket of space and had a decent opportunity. I'm sure he won't be pleased with the final product because that's got to be on target. But situation where Orange County could have found themselves in dreamland.
Steris now for the Galaxy. Aris. Romney. Got Diallo on the left if he can find him. Decides to go back instead. Now Steris. Covarrubias will wheel back. Not a good pass back. Steris keeps it alive.
Get it in the box at this point.
It'll come ahead for Bradford. Jamison gets away from the defender, and then he's dropped outside the area. This should be a card and a great free kick opportunity. Boy, just a step outside the box. Otherwise, that's a penalty.
Slippery as a snake is Jamison. Wheels just behind. Wasn't denial of a clear-cut goal-scoring opportunity, but a nice piece of athleticism here. And this is what we're talking about, finding that right pass. He sells the dummy. Navarro bites and is forced to make this foul. In the end, you'd have to say it was a smart decision made by Navarro, because if he doesn't make that foul, you find the situation where he's going to be clean through on goal.
Lassiter lining this one up. Aris is there, but I believe Lassiter will be taking this. On that left foot, the far post is where I believe Lassiter would be going.
Now, Aris has taken every one tonight. This sits up nicely for Lassiter's left foot. We know the venom that he's got from this position in that wonderful left foot of his. The question is, can he get it up and over the wall and under the crossbar?
It is close. Referee gives the go-ahead. Lassiter steps into this, tries to go on goal and over the bar and out. About 21 yards from that near post. That's a hard ask to get up and down.
Yeah, it is a big ask. You hit the nail right on the head there, Joe. And unfortunately, he did well initially to get it cleared over the wall, but dipped way, way too late.
3 minutes of added time here.
And they're not out of the woods just yet.
Nope. Miranda's goal kick. Knocked down by Steres. Possession, though, for OC for a moment. Good work here by Jameson. He'll get the free kick.
They've looked dangerous with Ramirez in there. He's brought a dimension, able to get in behind that we didn't see with Cortez.
They couldn't find Cortez. They found him the one, and he scored to his credit. But as far as getting him into the play on a routine basis, that was difficult for them.
Yeah, he never was a consistent threat. Didn't have the pace to trouble.
This ball comes in, surprises McBean, unfortunately. It'll go out of play. Defender was able to deflect that, we thought. No, goal kick. So the point would, if it ends this way, put the Galaxy in first place. You would have liked to see better, considering the fact that they controlled much of this match.
I think all in all, they'd be happy with the performance, but you know, when you talk about being up a man, last 15 minutes, surely 3 points is what you want.
Absolutely. And you look back and say, yeah, while you outplayed Orange County, now we'll see what happens here with Ramirez. He's brought down, and this could be a foul against the Galaxy and a card. Steres can't believe it.
Well, he's clever, isn't he, Ramirez?
Yellow
card. He has presented all kinds of problems. Really no argument there on that yellow card against Steres. But, well, he has really provided all kinds of fits for this L.A. defense. So take a look at it here. Technical, clever. He's got the pace and gets on the wrong side, or in his case, the right side of the central defense. And Los Dos really have to be careful, not just the situation on these counterattacks, but the resultant dead balls that come about after these calls.
This
it's not an auspicious way to end this game.
So it'll be a good opportunity here.
And right now, it's OC that look like they have the extra man.
Bradford Jameson decided to walk off his own version of 10 yards.
Do we see the foam spray?
No.
I don't know if we see it at
no
this level.
No foam spray here.
One of the best contributions the North American element has given the game. Saw it instituted at the World Cup.
Here's the restart. Going to goal over the bar and out of play.
Not a bad effort. It was always rising. Had the power behind it. Kind of sums up the finishing, though, emblematic of the way things have gone throughout the evening.
Closing moments now as the Galaxy try to get numbers forward, maybe for one more chance. Jack took a shot to the face. It's a foul the other way. Again, there's some words between the Galaxy forward and defenders. Yellow card to McBean.
I think a big question here in regards to this booking is, did McBean lead with that elbow? If that is the case, then, you know, 9 times out of 10, you're going to be booked for it. And interesting to see the future for Jack McBean. Where is he going to play? You know, he wants to be in that wide role, and you and I were talking about this off camera at halftime.
Right.
He likes to face up.
Well, he's not the back-to-goal forward right now.
And you see a player of his physique, his strength, that's the kind of play that you would expect to see out of a player like him. You know, it's almost, you know, in a different regard, situation with Zlatan Ibrahimovic, who drips those wide rolls, even though he's got the body to play that traditional number nine. But nonetheless, here, this one wraps up disappointing, you'd have to say, on the balance.
A tough comparison there, Christian.
It is. Yes, indeed. I'm not saying McBean's no Zlatan, however, back to the task at hand.
Right.
Great performance from LA Galaxy in terms of over 90 minutes, but the finishing was a little bit blunt-edged. I'm sure they will look back on this one and see it more as a situation of 2 points dropped than a point gain. Nonetheless, signs for improvement. They take first place, go top of the table, and extend that unbeaten run to 6 games. So all in all, positive night.
3 games against the OC Blues, no losses, and a 1-1 draw here tonight. Cortez, the goal for OC. Lassiter the goal for LA Galaxy. 1-1 the final. For Christian Miles, Joe Tutino, on behalf of our entire broadcast crew, we thank you for watching tonight. Final score once again, LA Galaxy 1, OC Blues 1. Have a good night.